We're getting you ready for, we're getting you ready for the onstage stuff. A lot of people coming, it's going to be fun. So I'll give you a few minutes of it, but I want to talk about something true and crazy, because I talk about true stuff a lot. My exes, for example, first ex, second ex had both. First ex, oh wow, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. But both of them, I think I give women the doo-doos. I can't say the other, I give them the doo-doos. And the reason I say that is because there's a couple things that happen. I know that with my first ex, we were on a honeymoon. And I said, hey, I'm gonna go get a soda. And so I go to the door and I turned and we're like lovey-dovey and stuff like that. And you know, give her a kiss. And as I'm going, she does like this. She, you know, like kicks her leg. And I'm like, I swung and missed it. I thought it was cute. And, but she starts standing there looking at me very strange. It's very strange. I start talking like Trump. It was very, very strange. And I was about to leave. And I said, well, why are you looking like that? She said, well, just hurry up and go and, you know, get the soda. And which made me want to stay more. I'm like, why are you acting like this? I don't understand. Like, well, just hurry up and go get the soda, is what she said. Unbeknownst to me, she had shat herself, you know? And I was standing there for a minute, and then the fumes came. And I'm looking at her, and I say, hey, what's that smell? And she said, just go get the soda, you know? I said, do you smell, it smells like a dog or something came and would you hurt? And she's tried to push the door. I said, wait, I said, I smell something. And I went forward and I was like, did you shat yourself? You know? So, but anyway, that was then. The second one though, it happened to her, you know, this was more like crazier. And I tell you, it's just totally crazy. I don't know why she did this, but was eating a lot of those A chocolates, you know, eating a lot of the aged chocolate. She was somewhere driving around all day, I don't know. She pulls into the garage and she's just sitting there in the car. I'm like, why is she sitting there? What's going on? And I walk over to the window. I'm like, I just stare. I'm like, what, why are you sitting here? And she's just looking at me like a deer in headlights. And I'm like, why is she doing this? So I open the door, she starts crying. And around her is a pile of, I'm talking about, doo-doo has come up, floated around the sides like a pool. You know, really. Because she, I guess she couldn't hold it, and bubbled up. And so I'm saying this for a reason. I'm going to get to the reason I'm saying this. Not only do I just, I don't know, I make women have the stomach. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but it happened, you know. It happened with her. She ate a lot of those candies and it caused her to do that. On a more romantic sense, I don't know if you can call this romantic. Me and the second one, we were taking a shower, you know, lovey-dovey, hey, blah, blah, blah. She's washing my back, washing her back, you know, stuff that married couples do. And I gave her the rag to, you know, wash herself off, you know. And I took the rag back. And I wiped across my chest. I was like, what the hell is this? You know, it was something brown across my chest. And I thought it was like, I don't know, some type of mud that she was using. And then I thought, wait a minute, I didn't see her get in here with any mud. All I saw her do was just wipe her body off and do like that. You know, I'm like, so where did this masking mud come from? And then I did like this and I was like, ooh, this, you know. Long story short, I guess she had taken a dump and forgot to properly wipe herself. Got in the shower, did that, and I wiped it across my chest. Hey, listen, that's enough of the doo-doo stories. I tell doo-doo stories a lot, you know. I got one doo-doo about my brother, too. I got this crazy thing with doo-doo. You know, some people have, like, they sniff stuff and smell stuff or smell bleach or stuff like that. I remember I threw a turd at my brother one time. He was sitting in the bathroom, and I was pissed at him. He had did something to me. Oh, this is terrible. Why am I telling this? Well, because it's a very long time ago. It's like what I did then, not now. Let's see how many minutes we got. Oh, we're 5 minutes in. Okay, we're going to wrap it up at 6. So anyway, he was sitting on the toilet, and I opened the door, and he's sitting there. He looks, and I had it, and I tossed it, and it came up, and it's almost in slow motion. I can still see his face now, what he did. It went up in the air, his face. It went up. And he didn't want to slap it or hit it because it's a piece of doo-doo. And he tried to go back like this and lean up against the toilet, and it came and it hit him right there and dropped down. And he kept his hands like this for the longest. Just, you know. Anyway, listen. That's crazy stuff. But listen, the comedy's coming. It's crazy comedy. It's truth. Sometimes that's the funniest stuff, the truth, right? Listen, General, out. Let's get some music before I depart.